What it is, Renegade Coaches in the motherfucking building.
Yeah. Yo, we back.
Here we go with that shit.
And we black.
Yeah.
Like that? You know you like that.
Nah, fuck that. That shit is.
You know what I'm saying?
Shit is, my man Kamal got this orange ass bib on today.
So
but we gonna get it right today.
I'm trying to do my social.
I'm glad. I'm glad.
Where your mask at, son?
My shit's right here, G. Just
yeah,
in case.
Shit
got my shit right again, here. Man. I got a ski mask too. Just get it fucked up. Anyway, it's Kalaji Jama Chang in the building.
Yo, what's good, Mal K. Franklin? How y'all doing out there?
And yo, I'll be the air doctor. What up?
We weren't ready to do that yet.
Yo,
we were going to converse.
I thought
you
I was.
Nah, we don't.
Come on, man.
I ain't down with the squad.
Yo,
you always down.
You supposed to be on your Jam Master J, nigga. You supposed to be spinning. You over there talking.
High
yeah. Anyway.
High looking. This
nigga look
come
like.
Come on, bro. We not gonna start cracking, are we?
Yo, I got my Renegade Coach T-shirt. My man finally delivered a T-shirt to us.
Yeah.
Took like 8 years, but you know we got it.
Yeah, we got it. True.
Nigga matching thanks to me.
Anyway,
we had a long ass week, man.
Yeah, man, a lot of good things happening, a lot of controversial things happening.
A whole lot of
important
shit.
Things happening out in the world today.
Yes, let's talk about this shit.
Yeah, man, no, I mean, we're not gonna get too deep into it, but you know, we had a special meeting with some artists, bringing together the old Black Panther Party or the veterans from the Black Panther Party with T.I., Killer Mike, Big Crit, and Luda. And had a good meeting. We're going to talk a little bit about it, but you know, there's more details to come. So we need y'all to stay tuned for that.
Yeah. So we're working on getting that right because of the fact that, you know, like Kwame Ture said, man, you know, our people are people. We have to give them the chance. You know what I'm saying? So oftentimes we get kind of upset. We want to cut a cat head off out the gate. But before we do that, one thing that's important, the whole political education, what political education has taught us is we have to give people the opportunity to decide what side of the barricades they're going to be on.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So that's what we did yesterday with the artists. And more important than the artists was the veteran Panthers or whatever, that the fact that the artists got to meet the true legends, those brothers and sisters who put in that soldier work before any of us was on this planet.
Yeah, what was so good too is that they stayed for about 5 or 6 days, the veteran Panthers. They met like people in our crew.
Yes.
We got to show them around. One of them was on our podcast.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So all that, those connections were made. Hopefully those connections will stay together. And I'm blessed just to say, like, you know, we know those cats who put the real struggle in. Like prison over 30 years, prison over 19 years, freeing Asada Shakur. These are real, true organizers, activists, revolutionaries. And it was a pleasure for us to host them for the week that we did.
And it was on the military side of things, because oftentimes folks get it twisted when they hear about the Black Panther Party. They think about the Breakfast of Children program. They think about the free health clinics and all that, which are all vital and necessary without a doubt. But at the same time, there were some bangers who decided that, you know, that they were going to respond. And if necessary, disagree violently with those who were being violent with them.
And speaking of that, so part of our show today is we got a new banger. Right?
Okay.
So when we come back from our break, we got this brother, Nicki Daniels. He's went viral. Nicki Daniels Jr., I believe. He went viral because he stood up to these white crackers who were, I'm using Kalonji's word. You know
oh
I mean.
My
you know God. I mean it.
Right.
You know what I mean
right.
it. I usually try to keep my lawyer veneer.
Look, come on.
You know what I'm saying? My man,
cracker smacker.
Me, you know. So my man stood up and tried to defend his sister, did, and he talked to the media about what he did. That shit went viral, so we got him here tonight. We're going to talk about what's going on here in Atlanta around the Wendy's that got burned down, the young sister that was killed, 8 years old, the tragedy, but also the organizing that took place on that Wendy's and how that needs to continue. And then we're going to get into some fun topics around fun and interesting.
Your boy Kanye
running for president.
Kanye.com.
Your girl Keisha got the COVID, you know.
Fuck
what I'm saying?
Keisha too.
And the NFL's about to do the Black National Anthem?
Fuck the NFL.
What the fuck is going on? So we're going to be back with Renegade Coaching, y'all, and hit it up.
Blackout.
Why are you guys out here with guns?
Why not? Those guys came on Sunday and they tried to intimidate some innocent women, ladies.
Women.
Unarmed men.
They got one of them right here.
They got one of them right there. Just post up right there. Just post this people
right there.
We came out here because those guys came out here trying to intimidate those girls. And they thought that they were going to have it easy. One phone call was made and the whole and everybody came down here on. No bullshit.
Chat Renegade Coach, you be back up in this motherfucker like blow.
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about, but yeah, we back up in here. How we starting off? What we got? What we got?
We got from Shreveport, Louisiana. His brother, we talked about him on the intro. Mm-hmm. I like this dude, man, because of the fact that, you know, we spotted him online and we saw the viral video. But the most important thing is we always see niggas with guns online. But we could tell when my man was dropping to these crackers.
Yeah.
That he's sincere. We can see the hood in him. Mm-hmm. And we can see that it wasn't no...
wasn't play actor time. He wasn't no actor.
Yeah, he wasn't one of these motherfuckers at the marches down here. With
yeah, it's almost like somebody did it. Like it's good somebody caught it on camera because he just was doing that shit probably every day, any day.
Right.
Right? And it was cool that somebody caught it.
So I want y'all to check out my man from...
Shreveport,
Louisiana, from the brand, the Gun Club.
Sleepers for the rich.
And Sleepers for the Rich Clothing. Welcome, my man, Nicki D. Yeah.
Corona, brother. I'm doing this. He already got like 12 diseases.
Yeah, I know. Ah! Put that shit on you in case Nicki brought it with him.
Man. Oh, man.
Well, how you doing?
Man, I'm good, man. Thank y'all for having me, bro.
Yeah, man. So we met the brother yesterday. We had this meeting that my man was talking about.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. T.I. brought him through and whatnot. And,
man, salute to Tip, man. Tip
had to redeem himself. You know what I'm saying? He said, he said, fuck Keisha, I'm going to come back with Nicki.
True that.
Shout out to Tip.
Yeah, I heard back. Tip was ruffling some feathers out here in the A, huh?
He was doing some things. Him and Mike, you know what I'm saying?
You got time to kind of give me a brief rundown on that, man?
A brief rundown?
We can do that. We're Renegade Culture.
So what the hell my man Tip do, man?
Well, they got on the news with Keisha, the mayor, and shit. And it was just basically saying that...
Keisha was telling black folks to get off the street.
To go home.
And she tried to get them to kind of co-sign on that. And they did a little bit. Right. They heard a little bit of like backlash from that, and I think they understood. You know, although they helped, you know, I think they feel a certain loyalty because they helped get her elected.
Right.
In fact, many say it was because of them at the last minute. They came out for a rally, and Keisha won by like 740 votes over this white woman who's been running the last couple of years. And
I remember.
So they got her in, and so she been hanging tight to these cats, and she called them up there because of some property damage at the CNN. And, you know, but the community was like, hold up, you know what I mean? You can't be telling black folks to get off the street after our folks have been killed by the cops.
Yeah,
if some property gets damaged and it saves some black lives, then fuck the property. We're more concerned about our folks being alive and being safe. We're more concerned about the cops getting off our backs, all that kind of good stuff. And I think they heard that because I think they turned around a little bit. It was like, you know what, we gotta pull forth a message that's more clear about what we mean. I think some of that's what led to the meeting with the Panthers.
Definitely.
And it's led to us potentially doing some good things together.
I can dig it, man.
So let's get back to you, bro, because you yourself now are a media star because of some actions that you took. So why don't you tell us
the power of the
what
internet,
happened, brother?
Man, the power of the internet. So pretty much what y'all saw on the viral video was me speaking to, let me rewind. So I initially got a phone call from a friend basically saying that some white boys was downtown bullying some peaceful protesters. So, you know, I'll start it off by saying I'm no kind of politician. I'm not any of that. I'm not on the left, I'm not on the right, I'm a businessman, I'm an entrepreneur, I'm an artist. But like I said, that was so close to home when I got that text message and that phone call. And then on top of that, I did just start a gun club, strictly for the purposes of, you know, for people of color to be able to protect themselves so people can be able to, you know, just feel safe about them, in life, man.
Yeah.
So like I said, whenever I got that phone call, the text message, you know, we sent the word out and we went down there with the intent in mind to pretty much protect those women down there. They were being pretty much harassed and yelled at and posters ripped out of their hand, pretty much assaulted.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So, and that's pretty much what it was.
By the time y'all got down there, was things still happening?
By the time we got down there, the KKK was pretty much still. They were pretty much still on the other side of the street.
Yeah.
But like I say, a lot of that shit was like it was it was tense. But you know, you can tell by them looking at the other side of the street.
Yeah.
That, you know, they knew they wasn't about to be what the hell. It was just
what happened five seconds ago.
So wasn't gonna be no more flyer ripping and shit.
It wasn't gonna be no more flyer ripping. They didn't cross Texas Street not one more time. You know what I'm saying? In fact, they were very cordial after that. You know, they seemed very mature. They were just sitting on the back of their trucks, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, like I said, they were still, you know, just, you know, talking, but, yeah, you know, yeah. It was, you know, the hostility.
No touching.
No antagonizing. It was no touching, no hostility, no antagonizing, none of that. And that's the whole, that's the message behind that. That's the message. Yeah. So, like I said, I mean, a lot of people, I told somebody else, there's levels to this warfare. There's levels to this revolution. Everybody mm-hmm. plays a role. Absolutely. Everybody plays a part. Mm-hmm. I don't claim to know, you know, more than I do about politics you know, foreign affairs, anything like that. But I do know, you know, I know about self-defense. That's I know right. I have family members that I love. Mm-hmm. I know I got nieces. I have a daughter, man. My mom. I'm a mama's boy. You know what I'm saying? So it's really just those core values, man. I'm prior military. You know, to take it away, you know, to take it away from, you know, us. I mean, you know, I real deal serve this country. So, like I said, man, in the Air Force and the military, they say, you know, defending against enemies, foreign and domestic. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So, foreign, of course, means any enemies across the water. Domestic means terrorist. You know, United States terrorists.
Yeah, that's right.
And who is the biggest terrorist on United States soil?
Yeah, right. The police.
You know what I'm saying? The police.
Yeah.
You know, racist.
Yeah.
You know, so that's what that is, man. So,
so when they hit you, so when the dude put the camera and you said what you said, did you expect any? You know, it's kind of hard to say like what's going to happen after that.
It's very.
And
hard.
When you figured out what happened, where were you? What were you watching? Or would you look at your Instagram or something? And it was like, what the fuck?
So, and this is the way God works, man. You know, it's always a silver lining in a dark cloud.
Yeah.
So the reason it went viral is because this biased news station in my town, KTBS3, they tried to make me and the my gun club members and a few of the other brothers that were standing next to me when I was giving my speech.
Yeah.
They called us gun-toting sympathizers. Mm. They said gun-toting sympathizers arrive at peaceful protesters. You know, so, I'm paraphrasing, you could look it up.
Yeah.
So who the fuck y'all supposed to be sympathizing with? The victims or the?
Good damn question, my man. So like I said, they called us gun-toting sympathizers, but nowhere in the article, nowhere did they show photos of the Confederate, the white Confederate KKK members.
They're just trying to set it up to make y'all look like y'all were the militant, bad, black folks with guns.
Yes.
Instead of being peaceful and all that kind of stuff.
They skipped the sequence. They were supposed to go, okay, peaceful protesters arrive, KKK members arrive.
Yes.
Trill cats with guns
arrive.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
News station arrives.
That's right.
Interviews leader of Trill cats with guns. Viral moment happens. Yeah. And then, but you see the devilish media.
That's right.
They're going to skip step one. Step two.
Yeah.
You know, the peaceful protesters arrive, but they're going to skip the part where those KKK members showed up.
And what's the name of that station?
KTBS3.
We like to say fuck. Motherfucker, KTBS3, straight from Renegade Culture.
In Shreveport, Louisiana, man.
Eat a dick sandwich if you have to.
Oh, damn.
And that's just how it's going to be.
Man.
Blackout.
Boom.
Anyway, proceed.
Man. That's, you know.
So how did you find out the shit went viral?
Man.
What did you down?
Because the people in my city that got love for me,
yeah.
they were tagging me. And you know, when they clap, they're clapping back under the news station's, you know, comment.
Yeah.
You know, piece of my man Ryan Williams, another young brother. He's just as, you know, militant as me, but he has a little more, you know, discipline when it comes to that paperwork. And, you know, he'll pencil whip your ass to death. You know what I'm saying? So, where my main camera at? You know
right,
what I'm
right
saying?
Over here.
Bob, shout out to my man Ryan. You know what I'm saying? He's still on their ass.
Okay,
he's still on their ass, like pursuing, like, well, like I say, he on their ass.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, but the way I found out about it is the people in my town, Shreveport, they got love for me.
Yeah.
They going under the post. Y'all, they're gun-toting sympathizers, but y'all didn't, you know, everything our folks, our black people gonna say, they getting on their ass about it, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So, my wise counsel, my mentors, they told me, look, Nick, you know, you don't say nothing.
Yeah, let them handle
it. Let your people handle that.
That's what you're supposed to do. You already said what you said.
I said what I said.
Yeah,
what I'm saying? The energy is out there. Energy never dies. And I said that in one of the Facebook Live videos.
Yeah.
And I was basically saying that to any brother who may have fear about speaking their mind or something.
Don't worry
about that. We all gotta go. We all gotta die one day, man. Mm-hmm. But the energy never dies. That's look right. How we still being motivated by Nipsey Hussle.
True. That's
right.
Pop.
That's right. That's
how we can still listen to a passionate speech by Malcolm X or Muhammad Ali.
Mm-hmm.
You
that's
know what right. I'm saying? What Muhammad Ali say? The devil wants us to believe that heaven is in the sky and hell is underground while he takes everything in
mm-hmm.
between.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Exactly.
You ain't got to be like, you know, that's, I think a 15-year-old can understand that.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? That's powerful and that's simple to understand, man.
So let me ask you this, because of the fact that, you know, your role in this shit is important because of the fact that the thing you were saying, you was like, look, I ain't no politician. I don't consider myself a freedom fighter and all that. You just love your people. You just like, look, I'm a businessman. My people's called me and said that these crackers was out of line and shit. So we showed the fuck up to see if they were still gonna be out of line when we showed
facts.
Up, right?
Facts.
So what you did, see, cause a lot of motherfuckers, they say, you know, well, you know, I ain't no scholar and I ain't no this. Everybody has a role to play, like mm-hmm. you said. You know what I mean? So
yes,
you don't have to be no ranting, raving lunatic. You don't have to be no bookworm. You ain't got to be a nigga that's running around with red, black, green drawers on. You can say, I just give a fuck about the people. In fact, you saying you came out the military. So
yes,
you were serving this motherfucker before, even though this motherfucker was serving you at the same time.
Man.
I want to talk about what, because they say people get involved in movement and struggle through inspiration, aspiration, or desperation, right?
Yes, sir.
So which was it for you? Was it inspiration, was it aspiration, or was it a desperate act, do you think?
For getting involved in the movement,
yeah,
or
yeah,
just
yeah.
my whole?
Yeah, just the whole, just saying, boom, I'm gonna get to this point. My folks called me, so I wanna be on the right side of the barricades.
Yeah. Basically, why'd you come out? Because you could have just been like, I'm gonna swipe that, or I'm not, you know, I'm like, I'm busy right now,
yeah.
somebody else take care of that. But you didn't do that, bro. You, like you said, no, like, you know, you're not this overt political dude, but you came out for your folks.
Inspiration, aspiration, or was it desperation? Inspiration. Was I inspired to come out? Yeah, I was inspired to go out there.
Word. So do you think it was the climate, or do you think it is just, you know, it's like...
I was inspired to go out there because, like I said, I told somebody else, man, we've all seen those black and white images of both sides, the peaceful, you know, the peaceful guys walking hand in hand in their mm-hmm. best church suits,
mm-hmm.
and they, you know, they got their shoes shined up, man, and you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. They nice neckties,
like him,
man.
Right?
Yeah. That's him?
Come on, yeah. Good.
On the red.
Young yeah. Rev.
I'm so a, look, I'm just mark that, I'll get back at you.
Yeah, I got you, I can dig it, I can dig it. But, so look, it was though, and those were the majority of the images that I saw when, you know, growing up in the Black Methodist Church, you know, going to church with mama and grandma, and you know,
right,
when it's
right.
you know, Black History Month, it was the pictures of Martin Luther King. But then it's like when I got older, I started seeing like, hold on, who was these guys with these berets on and these leather jackets and these pumps? These
yeah.
guys, why these guys look so much stronger? You know, even if it was just for appearances,
yeah, yeah.
even if it was just, not saying that they weren't strong, because we know they were,
yeah.
but even if it was just for marketing purposes,
yeah.
why is that catching my attention and resonating with me more than these guys, like, you know,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
getting sprayed, but we, you know, we gonna be all right, we
yeah,
shall
yeah.
overcome. Why that don't sit right with me?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So when you say, why did I go down there? It was pretty much me asking myself, man, what side of history you want to be on, bro?
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to be on the side of when it was going down? I could have went down there, but I just chose to just like, damn, just watch that shit on my Facebook Live
mm-hmm.
and wish them boys the best. Be careful, I heard there's snipers out there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know. And that's cool, thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah, yeah.
Because the people that, I didn't know it was snipers out there when I was out there
yeah, yeah, yeah.
talking shit. You know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
Thank you for the people that sent that message.
That's
thank
right.
you. You know what I'm saying? But like, we every day, my man, we wake up, we writing our story.
That's right.
So to answer that, yeah, I'm inspired. Every day I wake up, everything I do, I'm inspired because I feel like you know, my life is going to be a beautiful book one day.
Yeah.
At least I want it to be, or a movie. Maybe a book that gets transformed into a movie.
You never know. You're on the way.
Maybe a cool Netflix series.
Hey, you are Renegade Coaching. It's all the way up. Anyway, you checking out Renegade Coaching shit. We're going to go to a quick break. Wow. We're here with Nicki Daniels Jr. Uh-huh, uh-huh. You know what I'm saying? Nicki Daniels Jr., I like this cat right here. He went from Ashes Classy and shit. He was good fuckers. He's a street boy. They was at the joint yesterday. He's deeper than a motherfucker.
I know. Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Every cat that came up to me is like, yeah. I was like, where y'all from? I'm from Shreveport. We with him. Like, God damn. Hey,
you told him where you was from?
I told him I was from Bridgeport, Connecticut.
And then after they stopped laughing, then it was like, all right. Bridgeport? Who? Bridgeport? What? Bridgeport?
Fake on your hometown.
And listen. One of my other guys on here a couple weeks ago, what? Nigga was like church mouth. He's like,
Shit.
He said, yo, don't say shit about Bridgeport.
That? Anybody remember
Oh, y'all
that?
Don't?
Nobody remember
Let's go
that.
To the
bit. All right. Renegade Coach, yo. We be right back, yo.
Greetings, I am Toya M. Nelson and welcome to Inside Problems and Solutions. Today, I am going to give you a few tips on gun safety. There are 5 main rules on gun safety. The number 1 rule is treat all guns as though they are loaded. Number 2, keep your muzzle pointed in a safe direction. Here is your gun, here is the muzzle. Number 3, keep your finger off the trigger. Number 4, be aware of your target surroundings. Number 5, never try to catch a falling gun. Those are your 5 safety rules when dealing with firearms. Thank you for joining me on Inside Problems and Solutions. I'll see you next time. Peace.
Renegade Coaches in the building.
Yo, we back live, you know what I'm saying?
We got the Ear Doctor on the wheels.
Hey.
Playback Sounds, Playback Studios, they doing it up good.
We're gonna partner Kamal Franklin in the building today.
Oh, that was it? Oh, my man, Kalonji K, I said K, my bad.
Snigger,
my man, Kalonji J. Changa,
right here.
Right there, my bad, I was so shocked that you were trying to be nice to me.
See why I don't be nice,
I'm not used to that,
Yeah,
Wait a minute, my man, Nicki, because I saw you pulling down the shorts and stuff. Is this your gear? Anything on here that's like, what you
make?
This is actually
a one-of-one right here. You know,
what's your company again? Now you say your company.
The name of my brand is called Sleep is for the Rich Clothing. You can follow us on Instagram at Sleep is for the Rich. Sleep is for the rich. Yes, sir. But yeah, like I said, this is a one of one. Just, you know, I do a lot of in-house printing.
You might get out the camera shot. I'm not sure you know who's doing that, man.
Okay, stay seated.
Professional operation here.
Okay, gotcha.
It's so professional, we can't move the cameras when you move. So you know what I'm saying?
No kind of wide, super wide.
No wide shot.
We're going to get that
over. We're
going to be as wide as how the fuck we are right here. Fuck out wide. You get any bigger over the time.
I can dig.
Go ahead, show what you're going to show.
But no, like I said, this is just a one-on-one piece, man. Sometimes I just play around with some things at the house, bro.
Yeah.
This is some just a quick proverbs I put on the back, something I live by. Do not love sleep or you will grow poor. Stay awake and you will have food to spare.
So,
and that's just, you know, I like to find, you know,
nice.
you know, verses in the word, man. It just kind of lines up with the hustle, man, and
just
you know, building and, you know, that the lifestyle that I live, my man.
We gotta connect you to our man Rob Love from Guerrilla Republic. Shout out Rob Love.
Okay.
Rob said when we had 4 Eyes on, we ain't shot Guerrilla Republic out.
Oh,
so I'm shouting your ass out right now. Don't start nothing, it won't be there. You got a clothing line out here as well.
Okay. Shout out to the homie, man. Keep pushing, dog.
Yeah. So anyway, we back on this joint during our break. We heard some information that, you know, before this thing went viral, the media put out a photo of you.
Yes.
Can you talk about that?
Yeah, so basically what they did before adding any context to what went on, like I said, skipping step 2, which was the Confederates showing up, you know, without any kind of context, all they did was put up a photo of just a still shot of the video.
Yeah.
And of course the still shot was the most
black,
you know,
man with a gun.
Black man with a gun, you know.
He's dangerous.
I'm growling, you know what I'm saying?
Little angry ass Nicki and shit.
Yeah, little angry Nicki, man, veins protruding, you know. Tattoo on my, like, you know, like, all right.
They pulled the sidewalk up. He looked like 3 feet tall.
They shot from the bottom, so I looked like I was 6'5", you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, man. But
made them darker and shit.
Yeah, all that.
Crackers do.
All
America's
man.
Worst nightmare.
Oh, they slick, dog. They slick.
That's how they do. That's their job.
Ooh, they slick, man.
Yeah.
But like I said, they put that image out first But that's the power of the internet. Yeah. That's the power of Instagram Live, Facebook Live. The moment they put that photo up and just that photo only,
yeah,
the people that love me in Shreveport immediately got on their ass. Like, oh, word? Y'all gonna do it like that? That's the only picture, that no context, right?
Yeah, right.
And then hours later, now they wanna put, you know, okay, let's go ahead and scramble and put some and shit together.
Let's do some news.
Yeah, damage control.
Yeah, because people responded.
Yeah, because the people, and salute to everybody in Shreveport that got love for me, that jumped them under KTBS3's comments or made a post and tagged them in it, you know, cussing and fussing and debating or whatever you did in the name of me and, you know, the love that you got for me, man, I appreciate that, man.
And so then you made national news, right?
That thing had some legs on it, man. Yeah. It went everywhere, man.
So how'd you end up over here, man? Because, you know, folks are like, damn, this dude from Shreveport. Because here at Renegade Coach, we have every motherfucking body who is somebody.
True, you know what I mean?
So it's not a coincidence. It's not some shit in front of the sky.
Yeah,
we got fucking Nicki Daniels Jr. up in this motherfucker.
Don't
get it twisted. You know what I mean? We had everybody in this motherfucker from him to them. You know what I'm saying?
All the motherfuckers in between.
All in between.
I'm glad you named everybody.
If you ain't been on Renegade Coach and shit, you're slipping. You're slipping. There's a couple cats that ain't made it. Yeah, they ain't gonna name it.
So just like, so at some point T.I. got in touch with you. Is that?
Well, first off, what we not gonna do is forget about Tiny.
Tiny.
His
cream. Okay. No,
that's what we ain't gonna do.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Tell the story.
Stay in your place, man.
My bad. Tell the story.
Trying to make Tiny too small.
Like I said, shout out to Tiny because, like I say, she actually posted the video first.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
Tiny actually posted the video first.
Right? Okay.
And then, you know, they're one. So, of course, the queen, Tip picked up on it.
Mm-hmm.
And Tip say when he saw it, he was like, who is this young black man fussing at me with a gun in his hand? You know how Tip talk, you know what I'm saying? So Tip put the word out like, man, look, man, whoever know little bro, man, tell him to holler at me. And once again, man, the power of the internet. You know what I'm saying? And, I mean, word travel fast. You know, my people, I got people texting me, hey, you know, T.I. is looking for you. You know what I'm saying? Like, life changes on you quick, dog.
Right.
You know, one minute you just, you know, doing your thing, just, you know, living life.
So it went from fuck Nicki to I fuck with Nicki.
Yeah, hey, but like I said, I can't say, man, look, I've been getting love a long time in the South, in my town, just because, you know, I try to stand for something, you know what I'm saying? So, like I say, it's always a few clowns, you know, and I'm going to get y'all to give me some advice on how to deal with a little bit of, you know, just, you know, hate, you know, when
it, now you just smack the shit out a couple
just
of
times.
Don't
do whatever Kalani is doing.
Do the ass me,
so me and you are rapping about that.
Knock a couple bicuspids and rollers out of nigga. Smack their ass to sleep.
I got that.
Punch some shit down like I said.
That's all you
gotta do. He wants you to stay on the high.
That's what I'm saying, man. Kalani trying to get me out there, man. I'm a peaceful warrior.
There you go, brother.
You gonna be a monkey, be a gorilla out there.
You only pull it when you gotta pull it.
You gotta keep just doing what you're doing. That's it. Don't even think about them.
Word.
I can dig it, man.
Fuck them
on
the real. Yeah.
Well, look, while we on it, and I promise we ain't got to spend long on this, man. But you know, it's the picture old rapper in town. He been trying to get on all his life.
Yeah. Right.
Been trying to rap trying to make it big as a rapper all his life.
The ear doctor.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And you know, he's getting kind of old. You know what I'm saying? But he's still trying.
Like, when will my time come?
But the little kid out of high school that dropped the one mixtape with the dance to go with it. Got a motherfucking dance to go with it.
And he fired.
He out of here.
Right.
He put the whole city on the map.
Uh-huh.
He hadn't had boots on the ground as long as OG Rapper.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But the market, like Gary Vee says, the market don't lie, right?
Yeah.
So to make, you know, how would someone like myself, that's kind of what I'm dealing with, you know, not very many, it's just a very, very, very small percentage.
Yeah.
But it's you know, there's people that feel like I haven't been in this activism game long enough to be on these type of platforms shit.
No. Right.
You know what I'm saying?
What you did was some real shit.
G-shit.
You did what activists and organizers want to do, but a lot of them ain't got the guts or nerve to do it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So you should, I mean,
you're
speaking for your people. You speak, and with time, my assumption is you're gonna read more, you're gonna view more, you're gonna talk to more people. So all this stuff around organizing and activism that you gotta learn in terms of the history, that's gonna come with time.
Yeah.
But you did something, you made a bold statement that is now has its place in the history of our people.
Right.
And nobody can take that away from you, brother.
On the international level.
From you. You know what I mean?
And yesterday, you were in the room with some
heavy hitters.
You was able to see your older self. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Mm. Because the brothers that you was in the room yesterday, these are cats that already, they did that shit before. I mean, Sekou Odinga did 33 years, you 35. Imagine you being locked up all but 2 years of your life. That's how long he was in prison alone. You know what I'm saying? As Daruba said, he did more time in the child line than niggas did on for life. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So the thing is, you can't worry about what another motherfucker talking about or thinking. That's just the law of the land.
Just keep making moves, yeah. Keep talking to people.
Yeah, we quote Pop.
Don't worry about them.
Niggas gonna hate you for whatever you do.
And stay in touch.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah. Get on the right side.
Anytime you need support, we here for you, bro. Yeah, that's you know. So I mean, we want to keep talking about this. We also want to switch because there's some other stuff happening here in Atlanta proper. And
this man just said Atlanta proper.
Atlanta proper. You can't.
You
can't speak to King's English.
Atlanta proper.
You can't speak to
King's
English.
Nah, because I'm improper.
Oh, that's your king.
That's his king.
All right, here we go.
Say hello to your king.
Oh, my bad.
This nigga right here.
I'm sorry. Morris Brown in the house.
King George eating motherfucker.
Morris Brown education in the house. We can't fuck with that.
Who's your king? Don King.
Right here.
That's what's up.
Don't.
I remember Outkast made a song called Morris Brown.
Yeah.
Then shut down.
To college without no accreditation.
It ain't been open since.
Yeah, you know.
Back to your king. Back to your king's English.
But you know what I'm saying? So here in Atlanta.
Yes.
There's been a lot of shit going on. So we had the brother, Rashad Brooks, who was killed a few weeks ago.
Murdered.
Man. At the Wendy's by a cop, shot as he was running. Yes. Protesters, organizers. And again, folks from the community. Not even like folks like me who have been organizers for 30 years. These folks from the community decided that they were going to take over that Wendy's. Somebody burnt that shit down. Yes. Rightfully so.
Shout out to Joan Brown.
Rightfully so.
The white girl.
Shout out to the white girl.
The white girl burned it down.
It's supposed to be his girlfriend. She came through.
Well, we ain't got no evidence of that.
We ain't got no evidence.
That's an allegation.
We ain't Judge Wapner, nobody like that.
We got all that.
She came through with the motherfucking Molotov.
Somebody popped the torch.
Lit that bitch on fire.
So, and then the community came and took it over.
Yes.
They were there for weeks. They started doing youth programs.
Beautiful.
They started having like giving out food.
Yes.
They started doing some trainings, and there were young cats from the neighborhood who started surrounding it, and they had their guns out so that the police and other folks who were making threats, like again, Klan folks and all that stuff, they were going right up there so that they couldn't come and take back the Wendy's. And they were negotiating with the owners to turn that property into a peace center in memory of Brooks, who was killed there. Because they were like, there's no way that this place can go back to being a fast food restaurant.
Nah.
There's no way that you can put some other corporate establishment here and not remember what took place on this ground. This ground is now sacred ground.
Right.
So just like in other places, though, when black folks start to move and take over things, all of a sudden, funny shit start happening that gives the police an excuse. And a terrible thing did happen. This young girl, her name is...
Sha'Carria Turner.
Sha'Carria Turner. She was riding with her parents. And apparently she was killed by a shot. That killed her, and she was rushed to the hospital, and she died. And there's conflicting stories. The narrative is different. The city is putting out the narrative that it had to do with some people who were guarding the space. The people at the space who were actually there saying that there were no shots fired from their side. There was an actual back and forth between people on the opposite side of the space and the drivers of that car, and that's what took place. So there's opposing narratives. But the city has used this to move on the space, and they basically, with the owner's permission, try to move everybody off the space and now take it over.
Right.
And so we're working with that. We're working with the group of folks who are with the space to try to say, hey, you can't, the city, you just can't do that. You can't come and say that you're going to take this space back and the community no longer has a role to play. Terrible incident and tragedy, but it doesn't stop there.
And we want to say that indeed, you know, we our hearts go out to young sister Sha'Carria Turner and her family. And it's a shame that Keisha, Lance Bottoms, with her slimy ass, had the audacity to use this tragedy to come talking about some fucking black-on-black crime.
Mm-hmm.
We ain't about to fall for that narrative shit. And we told y'all that this shit was coming with the whole defund the police situation because of the fact that they're looking for holes for primary and secondary predators to come in and to commit havoc and cause havoc and fuck shit up. So we're not going for it, so we're going to intervene. Now, while we're talking about that, something Kamau didn't mention that I'd like him to talk about because of the fact that we have a rally and protest coming up. Kamau got a visitor.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So we want to talk about how right now they're turning up the situation.
They're turning up the heat.
Trying to scare motherfuckers. my co-host, can you tell us about this?
My visit? Brother earlier today, so apparently I get a call on my phone. I'm chilling, I got my family at home.
He don't even answer the phone.
I was like, fuck that. I was like, all right, who that? And in fact, I didn't even answer. My daughter answered it and said, somebody strange on the phone. My 8-year-old daughter picked up my phone. I was like, who this on the phone? It's like, Lieutenant Perry from Atlanta Police Department, surrogate to or working with Homeland Security. Hmm. And then he was like, I've been trying to reach out to you guys. Apparently he came to our community house and he left a card, and he's inboxed us from our website and left a message trying to figure out what's happening in terms of our rally this weekend. So
he couldn't read the flyer.
He couldn't. I was like, what's going on with you?
Get hooked on phonics. Stupid. What was his name?
I think it was like Lieutenant Perry or some shit like that.
Yeah, fuck you, Lieutenant
Perry.
You
know what I'm saying? I was like, what's going on? I was like, so we have, my legal training kicked in, and it was like, you know, so you know that the owner's working with us and you guys can't. It's like, we have a constitutional right.
That's right.
To march and rally. And we're gonna practice that right. Mm-hmm. And he was like, well, you can't block the sidewalk. It's like, as long as we leave a space open for people to pass by, you cannot legally stop us.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
And if you try to stop us, we won't allow you to stop us. Mm-hmm. We'll be exercising our constitutional rights this Saturday at 2:00. Right. You wanna be there, and we're gonna be there. Yeah. We can all keep it peaceful.
Yeah. See, they know Kamau's a former practicing lawyer and shit. Right. And that motherfucker dust off the law books. I get a call, somebody's whispering, look at Lodge in here.
Oh, yeah.
I said, what? What shall I do? I said, tell me you're a lawyer, nigga.
Hey, how long would I have to go to school to be a decent
attorney?
Attorney. I don't even want to do it in the court every day.
Yeah, well, don't ask him. You're going to be decent.
Well, you can ask him from the perspective of somebody who's been inside, but that's not fair. Okay? It didn't deserve service time well from what I heard. You just got to finish college and do 3 years.
Say it again.
College, and then you got to do 3 years, and that's law school.
Word.
Yeah.
So just regular college, four years of college.
And then you got to do 3 years of law school.
3 years of college. Law school.
That's right. That's all you got
to
do.
Now, to not have to deal with all that, what's one book you can read?
The Morris Brown.
Nothing for Morris Brown. Anything within the curriculum of Morris Brown.
Yeah, that's what I like. I'm
trying to help you. They don't get it. Listen, so he won the street ass.
He just got out yesterday. Nigga talking about, I'm ass him.
Matter of fact, what do the guys in prison study when they come out on some
They have law libraries. They study.
They have law libraries.
Look, there's no one book that teaches you how to practice law.
Yeah, it's not
And no good, no good, inmate who practice, inmate lawyer who does that stuff, they don't do it from one book. It's
because you got to study a lot of cases.
You got to learn case law. You got to figure out what courts you're going to file in. You got to figure out what's the appeal, what you're writing about. So that takes time and some practice. So there are good jailhouse lawyers. There's some good jailhouse lawyers that are better than lawyer practitioners because they've been doing it for so long.
Damn.
But it takes time to study. That's all. It ain't by no means is it impossible for anybody to do. That's not putting it there. But it just takes some time to study.
Well, not to cut off Nicki's law career and shit, because they ain't letting your ass go to law school no time soon. You a threat like us, motherfucker. I'd like to be an attorney.
You know what I'm saying?
Just stick around.
Corporation, trademarks, whatever. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You get the discount price.
How much shit have I blacklisted myself from with this revolutionary shit?
Oh, everything. Today you solidified it all the way. Yesterday you was on your way. So what highway y'all came down?
Well, it's not important.
Yeah.
There you go.
Okay, all right.
That's nice touch, right there.
I've been around him so much, I'm fucking up.
See that?
I didn't come out.
Wait, my bad.
Come on, get your money back.
Yo, Renegade Culture, we be back.
We back in a minute. Hey, this the main motherfucker.
History. Look it up. Everything them ball heads touch, they fuck it up. Every government is set up, it be corrupt.
Revolution. Revolution.
Dead prayers, people army, Steve Marley, ghetto youth crew. What you know is who you are. Who are you? Do you know who you are in the world? What is your worldview? What do you go through? What has your life shown you? What are you learning in this?
Learning.
Renegade Coaches in the building.
Yo.
The number one podcast on the whole motherfucking planet.
Word.
In the universe.
E, the N, the E, the G, the A, the D, the E is Renegade.
Word
Renegade
up.
Culture.
Oh. Word up. Anyway.
Oh, he don't like that.
I hate that fucking song, but it's growing on me after 73 episodes and shit.
What you?
I guess I might get
ladies,
used to it.
Ladies and gentlemen, please don't adjust your TV set. He actually is wearing that shirt, and it is those colors.
Woo! He got his pajama shirt.
Oh,
he forgot
shit.
To change out of that.
Oh, shit.
J.C. Penney special.
I'm getting clowned by get a nigga with a succotash, succotash tie-dye shirt.
Tie-dye.
Interesting.
Yo, yo,
right
yo.
Here.
Yo, come on, man.
Right, here we go.
Somebody needs to iron that shit for you. Yo, we got a bold question for you. Bold question.
All right, let's get
it. So, son, our bold question, we asked a question. Well, you pick a question out,
right.
And then we, you know, answer the question. Damn. So you were saying, like, you was on T.I.'s show, though, real quick. And
yes.
What did he have for y'all?
He had some tequila.
Yeah, tequila.
I don't know what to make it. I don't know which particular.
Okay.
Yeah, but yeah.
We had no tequila for you, though.
It was very it was smooth.
We got to get our production
smooth.
Up.
Smooth.
We get you some water.
T.I. is a millionaire.
Can we get you some water?
We ain't a hood, nigga.
Y'all ain't a hood. Yo, pick a quick question.
All right, bum.
There you go. Read that out. My man, the DJ wrote it, so we apologize.
Knock a nonsense.
You know how to read Braille?
Yeah. Braille.
Feel your way through that shit.
All right, so here we go. Do you keep your gun in your house hidden or in plain sight? All right, so when I'm there, it's right there on me. When I'm in the shower, it's right there.
Oh, goddamn.
When I'm making love to my queen, it's right there. When I'm scrambling eggs, three eggs with a dash of milk, pinch of salt, a little bit of pepper, stir that thing up.
The gun is right there.
It's right there on the side.
Hold up.
You never used the gun to stir with? Nothing like you don't fuck it up that kind
of thing? When you said, making love to my woman, I seen over there like, hold on.
You know what I'm saying?
We don't need to know all that. It's TMI. We don't want to know what the fuck little Nicki doing in the bedroom.
No, man. Hey, man, you got to get the good, the bad, and the ugly, my man.
No doubt.
That's what
it do.
Hey, but I say that for a reason,
so
boys won't get complacent, even in their own home.
True indeed.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, it's funny, but like, no, even when you know, taking a shit, like, when you outside on the grill, flipping that salmon.
Yeah.
You know, I just, during quarantine, I got my grill game up, so I'm somewhat of a grill master, but that's neither here nor there.
So you'll be doing YouTube videos and shit?
Facts. Custom sleepers for the rich, you know, mastery aprons, all of that. You know?
I like that promo you just did.
You saw that?
That was nice.
We're gonna charge you for the next one.
Just gonna drop that in there. but man, that's all I'm about, man. Like I said, I don't claim to know everything about all facets of the, you know, of the revolution and all levels of warfare. But what I do know is I love my people, bro. You know, I'm a businessman. Like I told you before, I'm trying to make some money, dog. I'm the kid that had the Hot Wheels when he was small, you know, with the posters of the Ferraris on the wall, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, typical American black boy dream, you know, a dreamer, you know what I'm saying? Like, I still want a lot of that shit, man. You know what I'm saying?
So,
you know, I mean, man, that's what that is, man. Like, you know, that's what that is, bro.
We got you.
So, let me ask you this right now. We got around the country, police is acting a motherfucking fool.
Mm-hmm.
You know, for folks who are just hearing about Shreveport, because of the fact that oftentimes we take for granted that wherever we from, you know, the world knows about it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Of course, people, when you think of Louisiana, the first thing most folks think about is either New Orleans or Baton Rouge.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Tell us about Shreveport. What's the climate like out there? Police friendly? Is it officer friendly, coming playing basketball, buying ice cream for the kids in the community? You know what I'm saying? What's it like?
You know, I think lately the police department has been very, very, very lax. That was a big reason why we felt compelled to go out there that day, because whether y'all know it or not, it was cops out there on the same sidewalk that the Confederate, like, cops were literally about 5 or 6 feet away from those Confederate men with guns yelling right damn near, you know, arm's length away, you know, yelling out obscenities, telling other male protesters what they, you know, to yelling out obscenities, you know what I'm saying? Making sexual references and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Like, cops or the white boys? I mean,
the Confederates is saying this shit to the protesters.
And the cops,
like
sexual
and the cops is just, you know, yeah, like it was one video, and if y'all need it, you let me know. I can get y'all anything for post-production. There was one video of one of the Confederate KKK women snatching, like viciously snatching a poster out of one of the peaceful protesters' hands, ripping that bitch up. And mind you, the protester that she was doing it to was a white protester.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that's, it's like they were really showing their rage, like towards like
their own,
Their own. You know, they call them nigger lovers, you know what I'm saying? Like they, you know, and I told some of the protesters that was listening to me speak, I said, hey, you know, I don't know if you know your history, but there were white allies back in the day. Mm-hmm. And but guess what? They got damn near abused and treated, if not, you know, just as, sometimes worse than black people. You know what I'm saying? Because like I said, they call them nigger lovers. Mm-hmm. So you better understand what you out here standing for and what I hope you're just not out here just for no IG likes.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like these people are, you know, looking at you the same way they're looking at us.
Yeah. Right.
See what I'm saying? So, so to answer your question as for concerning the police department, the police could be kind of lax, you know what I'm saying, when it comes to things like that. At least they were lax that day.
You know
what I'm saying? Now, I, on the same token, I can recall instances of police, Shreveport police officers helping me out. Mm-hmm. A homeless person stole my camera some weeks back. Mm-hmm. A Shreveport police officer, you know, stopped what he was doing, took 3 hours out of his schedule. You know, a guy named Officer Miller, and he helped me out. Mm-hmm. So like I say, there is a lot of bullshit that goes on. There is a lot of lazy ass Shreveport cops.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But like I say, I can't put that jacket on every one of them cops like that. Mm-hmm. But what I'm asking is, the good cops like Officer Miller, the other good cops, whoever you are, you know what I'm saying? The Officer Hurd, shout out to my dog Hurd, any other police officer, Officer Lewis Mason, all of y'all boys.
You just did something very rare. And we don't do no popo shouts out here. You can't wait with this.
Gotcha.
We fuck with you.
Gotcha. Wait, we shout out to
you. Big up to your man.
He's about to go off. He's about to throw a shout out. I'm just really for the first
row. Goddamn.
Fuck all that. Just fuck the police and Renegade coaches. We don't mean no harm. So you cutting them a third grade friend. It's still eat a dick. Nicki might shout you out, but fuck that.
Hey, look, we all
it's all good.
No.
We get to the point.
Look, and I respect that.
After a while, you keep hanging with us, you're going to be like, yeah, fuck Officer Miller. You'll be like, damn, I thought I was your dog.
I can get my camera back.
I can dig it, man.
Like, I don't even like that camera, bitch.
Yeah. You feel like you're going to stay in Shreveport, though?
I'm sorry, see you again.
You feel like you're going to stay in Shreveport?
Man, I love Shreveport, man. I love Shreveport like y'all love ATL.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
We don't really love Atlanta, but we hate it.
Well, look, I love Shreveport like somebody that's real deal from ATL.
Yeah.
I like
ATL.
That.
That's
true.
That's
true.
That's true.
Like, you know, just, and you just, you know, I Killer Mike, Outkast, Tip. I guess it's Keisha Bottoms, you know, Sister Keisha, is she from the A?
She's from the A.
Okay.
Yeah, she from there.
Okay, all right, well, bet. So, like I say, whatever.
Yeah,
you know, whatever.
We got you.
Anybody,
yeah.
We still like with say, you, my man.
Look, yeah. You know, it's still places in Shreveport that I, you know, that I used to pass by when me and my wife, you know, didn't have it.
Yeah.
Hey, we playing bingo at night. You know, hey, that's going to be our house. We still got shit we got to do in Shreveport.
That's right.
And on the real, and I was just bullshitting, we fuck with ATL hard because this is one of the places that we have gritted our teeth for, lack of better words. Mm-hmm. There's some real dope people out here, so we just talking shit on that. We still ain't shouting on the motherfucking police.
I can dig it.
Fuck the police, the governor, the mayor, and the president.
I can dig it.
And the Pope.
COVID Keisha.
All that shit.
COVID Keisha.
Yeah, fuck that. And shout out to my mom, because my mom sent me a text and shit. She said,
tell her stop talking about your shirt.
Nah,
she's like, I ironed that shirt, didn't I, before you left the house today?
y'all boys are wild, man.
Mom, excuse me when I say fuck these clowns. But anyway, my mother hit me up. She's like, Mayor Lance Bottom has COVID. I text back, good for her.
It'll keep off the camera for 2 weeks.
Yes, like, my mom hit me back. I ain't teach you to hate your people.
Yo, what about your boy? Your boy Kanye West, man, is running for president.
That's that nigga right there,
this
right?
This nigga's running for president. What's going on?
Kanye goofy ass.
Can that ask us some COVID? Can it be COVID,
I mean,
Kanye?
That nigga right there. I mean, I remember Kanye used to run with dead president shit back in the day.
Yeah, man.
Kanye was woke as fuck back in the day,
he said,
dog.
Bush don't love black people. Fuck Bush.
Damn, I had a shirt that said Kanye was right back in the day.
Yeah, that was
my favorite shirt, dog.
Yeah, and Kanye was on point for a minute, but, you know, power corrupts absolutely. Mm-hmm. You know, I think that right now
he wanted to live that Kardashian lifestyle.
Yeah,
you gotta pay attention though, man. I think, man, like
did
I say,
spike the shit?
No. I think sometimes you and I don't know. I could be wrong, man.
Spook, that's that behind the door. I'm telling you.
Come on, that's what I'm saying, bro.
Kanye?
Yep.
Look.
Let me hear the theory. Go ahead. Let me hear the theory.
Good.
Like I say, sometimes, bro. Like, and I think Jay-Z even hinted towards it, man. Like, if we gonna make a change, man, somebody's got to. Say me for instance. When were the hard heads and shit gonna step up and say, damn, dog, it took for little hustling ass, you know, car wash Nicki, t-shirt slanging Nicki, mm-hmm, to go down on Texas Street with them motherfucking assault rifles to charge us up. You know what I'm saying? He really just exposed himself to like everybody that you just, like, yeah, I'm, yeah, blacklisted, right, yeah, now, right, and shit. Right, I'm that, right, guy now and,
right,
shit.
Right,
the,
right,
face,
right,
of the,
right,
whatever.
Yeah, yeah, right, yeah.
So it's like, and that's, but that's the positive side. That's the revolution, you know. I just got dirty for the cause and
that's
shit, right?
That's right.
Well, maybe Kanye got to, in order to like get us on some billionaire type, trillionaire type shit, because he just bought a shitload of land in somewhere like Idaho or some weird, yeah, shit, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know, bro. Like, we so far at the bottom, and not at the bottom as in good and bad.
No, I know
just
what you mean. You know,
you know,
yeah,
like, it's, man,
class,
that man,
economics,
that man done been in some doors and he done seen some shit, man, that we just may not know, bro. So before, yeah, we just got to sit back and just see.
I would like right now, if I had to vote, and I stand by the welfare poets, we ain't vote to get into the shit, so we ain't gonna vote to get out, right?
Yeah.
I would say that I would vote for Kim Kardashian before Kanye Kardashian. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because at least she act like she on the right side of history. This dude got with this chick with fake titties and the fake ass, and he lost his goddamn rabbit ass mind. I don't know what the fuck she put in his soup, but that nigga got tipped all the way over.
But do you think she's pulling his strings? You think she got the say so over him?
No, I think.
Oh, I don't think nobody got.
Yeah,
the
I don't
say
think
so
nobody got.
I think.
You don't think Kim cracking that whip on Yeezy?
I mean, what,
no,
could be? I mean,
oh, I think there's a, well, I'm gonna jump in. I think there's a way in which she cracked the whip, but which he's like, you know what? I just want you, because I want the status symbol, right? I think he fell for the status symbol. And
he's trying to keep up with Jay-Z and
I think it was all that kind of shit.
Well, what I was gonna say was maybe if he does become president, if y'all dig Kim K so much, if that's his, maybe she's gonna be putting that that we want in his ear anyway.
Well, first, let's be clear.
You gonna become president
before Kanye West becomes president.
Will happen. I mean, shit, look at Trump. Yeah. What was Trump? A reality show star?
Yeah, he a cracker, though.
Yeah, cracker, yeah.
There's a difference between cracker and a cracker. Flavor Flav is a reality star. Right. You know what I mean? These ain't voting for Flavor Flav.
I can dig it.
Griff or Chuck.
Hey, y'all going to stand for the flag now at the NFL?
The NFL is going to do the Black National Anthem.
The Black National Anthem.
For a week, I think, right? And then before.
They get every game?
No, I think they're going to do it for a week. They ain't going to do it.
That's too much.
You know the Black National Anthem, brother?
Let the record reflect that I've been a black motherfucker for the majority of my days, in fact, all of my days, and to this day, if a motherfucker put the gun in my head and say,
you know,
she's a Black National Anthem, I'd be like,
well, no, the first verse, everybody know the first verse, though.
I don't know shit about
you know the first, lift every voice and sing, you don't know that shit?
No, I don't.
Because that's a Negro spiritual.
That's a Negro spiritual, yeah.
My man saying that Negro spiritual.
It is a Negro spiritual.
Negro spiritual, right?
Yeah. Basically, it is.
They always trying to give us that slave shit, man.
Wait a minute, you gotta know the lyrics, bro.
That is a history.
You gotta know the lyrics.
It's a slave shit.
To the song.
No, it's
not.
I'm not gonna sing the whole song. No, it is a song.
Let's start singing it, nigga, so we can understand.
Nah, nigga, you sing the song.
I don't know it. Yeah. You want to act like you know it. You don't know
it. I don't know the goddamn. Everybody
sing it, motherfucker.
Nigga, I'm not no plantation.
Who ready to
sing? Wait a minute. Let me just say this real quick.
Let me hear the lyrics.
No, lift every voice and sing to earth and heaven ring. Sing a song full of the faith of the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought.
Ladies and gentlemen, live for the
we used to say that in my mama's church. Let me stop. Mom, I'm sorry. I remember that.
The more hilarious thing is that even black folks don't know the second version. Nobody knows the second version. Y'all know the first verse, and that's it.
I know the second verse.
Now, the second verse,
my God, my Lord. That's it.
Ignorance.
Hold on. So, the second verse ain't got no coon shit in it.
No. Okay. I'm just saying that everybody knows the first. Everybody who's like my age and whatever, they all know the first verse.
Yeah.
But you know, you never did the whole. The song is long.
No, because that was like intermission. It was like before, like we did communion or something.
Yeah. That shit is long. It's a long song.
He remember communion and shit because he got extra wine.
Niggas
was going up there making different faces.
Man, what?
But ain't nobody. Ain't nobody believe that the NFL gives a fuck about black people.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Fuck the NFL.
Cause they about to sing the black national anthem.
Listen.
For 1 week during that thing.
Oh, it's just a week?
Hell yeah, they're not doing that shit.
Man, boy, they be throwing us crumbs, man.
That's what they believe in.
They be throwing us giblets, man.
Will they shut you up? What can we do to shut you up?
I haven't forgotten.
You mean to tell me
that you motherfuckers sing the national anthem? But when Kaepernick monkey ass got on there talking about kneeling, you motherfuckers went down for that shit. Now all of a sudden you niggas want to kneel, y'all want to squeal,
y'all want to pray.
You know what I'm saying? Well, fuck all that. Listen, man, I don't know the goddamn lyrics to the black national anthem, and I'm still not going to know it after Renegade Culture. And it ain't no diss to those of you that do know it. I'm just saying to you, the only song I'm interested in now is Burn Baby Burn, motherfucker.
Burn this bitch down.
That's what I'm talking about.
Renegade, so we going to come back with...
We're going to come back with, what's your man's
special
name, Jawuan?
Jawuan Ford, man. Peace and love to my man, Jawuan Ford. Shreveport's golden child, man. Hey, you heard the name first. Well, not first, shit, but, you know, remember the face, man. Remember the face.
You heard it on the most important fucking podcast.
Yeah, man.
That's right. We love Tip, but you number two, Tip.
We like him too. Expeditiously. Expeditiously. Shout out to Tip.
Peace and love to my man, Tip, man.
Second best podcast in the world.
He sent the city up, man. Put Shreveport on the map even more.
No doubt.
Yes, sir.
Second best podcast.
Second best podcast.
Coach. Anyway,
I can dig it, man.
We'll be right back at you.
All right.
Yo. You know what it is. All the way from Shreveport. You dig? I support you on. Free the world.
I'm thinking about the rappers I came up around who are targeted by police or either in the ground. From Soldier Slim down, my whole state of battleground. Niggas killing niggas, but the police kicking doors down. So don't ask me about my drugs, they make my soul smile. When they feel like I don't know how, you either get free by stretchers or try to become rich if they would let you. But you become a target when you trying to do better. It's a cycle. Designed to trap you and the people like you. They rather see you take it and help you make it just like I do. Cause you stupid. You let these fake rappers be your idol. But I am not impressed by niggas' titles. You see? I knew two niggas who was real tight. Now they shooting at each other trying to earn stripes. I'm supposed to trust my dog when it ain't going right. You must ain't heard who took Lil Snoop life. It ain't no friends. Out you gotta even watch your kin. Cause niggas gon' finesse them away in. That's why I swear to God, all I wanna do is win. So tell me what the fuck my hustle gotta do with them two baby Glocks, I call them twins. And pray you never see how cute they grin. You know what niggas do to pay their bills and buy a Benz? Imagine selling dope just to barely meet your ends. And when you make enough, you hear the police rushing in. I got some questions. I thought about BG when I heard this beat. I thought about how long they took to go set Lil Boosie free. It's sad to think about Lil Fat. My nigga, rest in peace. I'm from Louisiana where exit isn't guaranteed.
Jawuan in the building.
Yes, sir.
Thank you,
sir. Yes, sir. It's an honor to be here.
Thank y'all for having us, man. Thank y'all for having us, kid.
Yeah.
DJ, doctor. You know what it is, man.
Peace. Wow.